Welcome students. In today's video, we will study about types and other characteristics of leaves. In the last video, we studied about leaf and its parts. We now know that a typical leaf has three parts. Leaf base, a part which attaches the leaf to the axis. Petiole, which is a long tubular part which connects the main axis to the main part of the leaf, and leaf blade or lamina, which is the flattened green extended part of the leaf. It is the main part of the leaf which contains chlorophyll and has stomata, which helps in gaseous exchange and photosynthesis. Also, we studied about venation. Leaves have veins and veinlets in it, and arrangement of veins and veinlets in leaves is called venation. Venation is of two types: reticulate venation, where veins and veinlets form a network. It is the characteristic feature of dicot plants. The second type of venation is called parallel venation, where veins and veinlets run parallel to each other. It is found mostly in monopod plants. Now we will discuss the types of leaves. Students, leaves are basically of two types depending upon their leaf blade or lamina. The first type of leaf is called simple leaf. A simple leaf is a leaf in which the lamina is entire. You can see over here, the lamina is entire without any cut. So lamina is smooth and entire without any incisions or cut. Even if incisions present, in this case you can see incisions are there, the leaf is cut, but these cut do not reach to the midrib. This part of the leaf is called midrib, and incisions are far away from the midribs. Incisions do not reach to the midrib, so it is an intact leaf. It is called simple leaf. I have arranged examples of leaves for you also. See, this is a leaf with intact lamina. The lamina is not cut. It is intact without any incision, without any cut. It is an example of simple leaf. It is another leaf which is having cuts in it. You can see the leaf is having grooves and cuts, but the cuts are far away from midrib present over here. Midrib is somewhere here present, and cuts are over here. So cuts are not reaching up to the midrib. So these are the example of simple leaves. The second type of leaf is called compound leaf. These are the leaves which are cut. Incisions are there, and due to those cut, the cut are so deep that these cuts reach to the midrib and divides the leaf into a number of leaflets. Lamina is divided into very small pieces, very small parts called leaflets. Generally, when we look at those leaves, we may confuse the leaflets with leaves. I am showing you an example of such type of compound leaf. It is an example of compound leaf. This is neem leaf. Now, what do you think? How many leaves I am taking in my hand? You will start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 12, that side. These all are not leaves. This is a single leaf. These are leaflets. A single leaf has various cuts, and these that we generally consider as a single leaf is actually a part of this large leaf. So these are leaflets. Now, how we can say that this single leaflet, not a leaf. We have studied that the characteristic feature of leaves that in its axil, axil means the area, the point where it is connected to the main axis, there is always a bud present. An axillary bud is present over here. We cannot find any axillary bud over here, but axillary bud is present here. Here you can see the presence of axillary bud. Here is also axillary bud is present. It means at the base, it is the leaf base, it is the petiole, and it is midrib of the leaf. It is midrib of the leaf, which is now known as rachis, and different leaflets are arranged on this. Because in the axis of these leaflets, axillary buds are absent, so these are not leaves. Axillary bud is present over here, and hence this is a single leaf divided into various leaflets. So it is an example of compound leaf. Means compound leaves have cut lamina which divides it into number of leaflets. Compound leaf again is of two types, pinnate and palmate. Pinnate is the leaf where leaflets are present on rachis. The same example is there. The example is neem, rose, where coriander, where you can see a rachis. Rachis actually midrib of the leaf. This midrib, this is rachis. This is rachis, and leaflets are present on the rachis. This is called pinnate compound leaf. Examples are neem leaves, coriander leaves, rose leaves also. I am having rose leaf also. You can see these leaves are present over here. These are actually not leaves but leaflets, because in the axis of these leaves no axillary bud is present, but you can see presence of stipule and axillary bud over here. So it means it complete is a single leaf divided into various leaflets. The second type of compound leaf is called palmate compound leaf. Palmate compound leaf gives a palm-like appearance where all the leaflets arise from almost a common point. Leaflets are attached to a common point, and that's why they give a palm-like appearance over there. All the leaflets are arranged, attached to a common point. In pinnate, it is arranged with a gap on the rachis, but here rachis is condensed and all the leaves are present over here, and it is giving a palm-like appearance. All are spread, arise, attached to a common point. So it is called palmate compound leaves. So there are two types of leaves: simple leaves with entire intact lamina. Sometimes incisions are there, but those incisions are not deep enough to reach to the midrib. And the second is compound leaves, where leaves are cut in number of leaflets. These can be identified by presence of axillary buds, not in the axis of leaflets, but in the axis of leaves itself. Phyllotaxy. The phyllotaxy term refers to arrangement of leaves on a stem or branch. The study of phyllotaxy explains how the leaves are arranged on the stem or on the branch. So here we are going to study about the arrangement of leaves on the stem or on the branch. The phyllotaxy is of three types. First one is alternate. As the name suggests, here the leaves are arranged on the stem
in an alternate manner. It means at one node only a single leaf arises, and from the next node on opposite side another leaves arise. So leaves are present here in an alternate manner. One at one side and the next on the other side, and likewise so on. The example of alternate phyllotaxy is China rose. China rose, you can see one leaf is arising from this part, whereas another leaf is arising from this part on the next side. So it is going in an alternate manner. One this side, another this side, and likewise. So it is an example of alternate phyllotaxy. The second is termed as opposite phyllotaxy. Opposite phyllotaxy, where from one node two leaves in opposite direction arises. So it is called opposite phyllotaxy, where each node bears two leaves in opposite direction. This is called opposite phyllotaxy, and the example of this is guava. In guava, you can see two leaves are arising from one node. From one place, one single place, two leaves are arising. Then again, you can see over here, from a single node, two leaves are arising in an alternate manner. So such type of phyllotaxy, where from a single node, two leaves in a different, in a opposite direction arise, such type of phyllotaxy is called opposite phyllotaxy. The third one is called hold phyllotaxy, where more than one leaf arises from a common point, from a single node, which forms a hole like appearance. It is forming a hole like appearance around the stem because more than two leaves are arising from one place, and that's why it is like covering up the stem and forming a hole of the leaf. It is an example of hold phyllotaxy, where leaves are arising from a common point and it is like forming a hole around the stem. So there are three types of phyllotaxy. Again, phyllotaxy is arrangement of leaves on a stem or a branch is called phyllotaxy, and it is of three types. Alternate, where leaves arise in an alternate manner, from one node a single leaf and from the next node another leaf in opposite direction. The example is China rose. The second one is opposite phyllotaxy, where from a single node two leaves arise in opposite direction. That's why it is named as opposite. From each node two leaves are arising in an opposite direction. The example is guava. And the third type is called hold, where from a single point, from a single node, more than two leaves arise and it forms a hold like arrangement at the stem. It is called hold phyllotaxy. Example is Alstonia. Modifications of leaf. The primary function of leaf is to perform photosynthesis and to perform gaseous exchange. It is having chlorophyll and stomata, which help in photosynthesis and in gaseous exchange. So it is the basic primary function of leaf. Along with these functions, or apart from these functions, leaves sometimes are modified to perform different functions. Sometimes all the leaves of a plant are modified. Sometimes some leaves are performing their basic functions, whereas some leaves are modified. So leaves are modified to perform a lot of different functions and activities.
sometime along with its main function, and sometimes they only perform the new acquired function. So following are some modifications of leaves.
The very first modification where leaf forms tendrils. Leaf tendrils are spirally coiled like a structure present in the plant. It is found in the pea plant, and basically tendrils are there to provide support to the plants having weak stem. It helps the plant to climb up with the help of tendrils. Tendrils are found in creepers and climbers, and there these modifications of leaves provide support to the plant. Example is pea plant. The second example is leaf hooks. Sometimes, like in bignonia, in asparagus, leaf form hook-like structure. Some leaves form hook-like structure. Other leaves are present over there to perform photosynthesis. But some leaf forms hook-like structure, and there also these are to provide support and protection to the plant. The third modification of leaf is called leaf spines. It is a general modification found in the xerophytic plants like cactus. Leaves are reduced to form minute spines. The stem becomes green and fleshy, and leaf becomes very reduced to form spines. The leaves are there to protect the plant, as well as these are reduced mainly to reduce the rate of transpiration. Because these plants are xerophytic, so water conservation is important for them, and hence leaves having stomata perform transpiration. So the larger and longer leaves will remove more amount of water, and to reduce that water loss from the plant, leaves are reduced to form spines. So leaf spines are common modifications found in cactus and other xerophytic plants. The next leaf modification is of fleshy leaves. This modification is to store food. As we have studied in modification of stem also, that this is condensed disc-like structure. This is a stem, and above that the leaves become fleshy and store food in case of garlic and onion. So fleshy leaves are arranged in a compact manner on the condensed stem, and it is an example of fleshy leaves where leaves become fleshy to store food. Garlic and onion are the examples. And insectivorous plants. Some plants are insectivorous, as these plants trap insects to fulfill their nitrogen requirements. These plants have special structure to trap the insects. Their shape is modified in such a way that insects come and trap over there, and they can get nutrients, basically nitrogen, from those insects. An example is pitcher plant, where the leaves form a pitcher-like shape with a lid on it. The lid is always in a standing position, and this part, the rim part, is sticky. Whenever an insect sits over there, the lid puts off and insect is trapped inside the plant. So it is a modification of leaf to form special structure so that insects can be trapped inside the plant. These are some modifications of leaves. Leaf tendril to provide support, leaf hooks to provide support as well as to protect, leaf spines to reduce the rate of transpiration and to reduce water loss, fleshy leaves to store food, and insectivorous plants where leaves are arranged in such a manner or acquired such a shape that it helps the plant to trap the insects. Let's have a quick summary of the part leaf. Leaf are photosynthetic organ of the plant which performs the functions of photosynthesis. Following are the parts of the leaf. It has three parts: leaf base, which connects the leaf to the axis, petiole, the branch, and the lamina, the main part of the leaf. Then we studied about venation. Arrangement of veins and veinlets on leaf is called venation, and it is of two types: reticulate venation, where veins and veinlets form a network. It is called reticulate venation. It is found in dicot plants. And parallel venation, where veins and veinlets run parallel to each other. It is found in monocot plants mostly. We studied about types of leaves also. Now we know that leaves are basically of two types: simple leaves, when the entire lamina is intact, either without any cut, or if cut is present, it is not so deep so that it cannot reach the midrib. And the second type is compound leaves, where the midrib is cut and lamina is also cut so deep that it just touches the midrib. So here the midrib is called rachis, and on that various cut part of leaf called leaflets are arranged. It is again of two types: pinnate, where leaflets are arranged on a long rachis, and palmate, where leaflets are arranged on a short and condensed rachis in such a way that they appear to arise from a single point. Then we studied about phyllotaxy. Phyllotaxy refers to arrangement of leaves on a stem. It is of three types. In alternate, leaves are arranged in an alternate manner. One leaf on one side from a single node, and another leaf on another side from the next node. The second is opposite, where from a single node, two leaves arise in different opposite direction, and hold, where a single node bears more than two leaves, and that's why it forms a hole like appearance around the stem. Following are the modifications of leaves. Leaves are modified to form tendrils. It is to provide support to the plant. Example, pea plant. Leaves are modified to form hooks to provide support and protection, such as in bignonia. Leaves are also modified to spines. It is a characteristic feature of xerophytic plants, that is cactus. These are modified here to reduce the water loss by the process of transpiration. Leaves become fleshy to store food, such as in case of garlic and onion. And finally, leaves of insectivorous plants, which are modified to different shapes so that insects can be trapped inside them. That is, example, pitcher plant and Venus flytrap, etc. Now students, this is your assignment time. Here some questions are given. Write down the answers of these questions. You will get all the answers in the video itself. So first, watch the video carefully and then try to write down the answers of following questions. The first question: draw a typical leaf and show its part. Second question: define phyllotaxy. Explain its types with examples. Third, differentiate between a simple and a compound leaf. Fourth question: what is venation? What are its types? Explain with examples. And fifth question, describe different leaf modifications with examples. The questions are very easy and need not any explanation. So write down the answers. Thank you.